Hello, my name's James. I'm very happy to be able to talk to you about this subject. This is one of my favourite things. Well, you see, I'm a nerd. There I am. If being a mathematician wasn't clue enough, a big sign saying nerd pointing on my face would do it. But also, I'm a comedy nerd. There I am again. So, if you imagine the Venn diagram of my mathematical heroes intersecting with my comedy heroes, that, well, we don't have to imagine, there it is, then the sole point of intersection would be Tom Lehrer. So I was around my friend's house some years ago, my friend Steve, there he is, leaving the room by the looks of it. He's a comedy nerd as well, and I played him some Bonzo, there they are, but that's a talk for another time. And he played me this.
Spring is here, a suffering is here. Life is Skittles and life is beer. I think the loveliest time of the year is the spring. I do, don't you? Of course you do. But there's one thing that makes spring complete for me and makes every Sunday a treat for me. All the world seems in tune on a spring afternoon when we're poisoning pigeons in the park. Every Sunday you'll see my sweetheart and me as we poison the pigeons in the park. When they see us coming, the birdies all try and hide, but they still go for peanuts when coated with cyanide. My pulse will be quickening with each drop of strychnine we feed to a pigeon. It just takes a smidgen to poison a pigeon in the park.
Well, what was that, I thought. So I went out and bought the box set, and it was brilliant. It contains 3 albums and a few rarities on it. And I loved it. It was hilarious. And I couldn't believe that he got away with it. And he got away with it in the 50s. Now I'm beginning to realise that he didn't quite get away with it. But I also found out that he was a mathematician. Now, this is incidental. I mean, I think he's great. And he just happens to be a mathematician. But he considers himself to be an academic first and a performer second. Tom Lehrer, there's his picture, there's his standard publicity picture. I don't like it myself, he looks a bit creepy. He certainly doesn't look like the sort of person I would leave my kids with. It's probably the bow tie and the Brill Cream. I blame the 50s. However, this is Tom Lehrer, a singer, songwriter, pianist, mathematician, teacher, lover, poet, gentleman scholar, international playboy and diamond millionaire, Tom Lehrer, and has been described as the greatest satirist who ever lived. And Mark Russell should know, he stole Tom Lehrer's act. Well, I say stole, only in the same way you can steal somebody's beer by drinking their wee. Here are some of his other reviews, however, weren't so favourable. Mr. Lehrer's muse is not fettered by such inhibiting factors as taste. Some of his other reviews, which all appear on his records, by the way, include more desperate than amusing. The Christian Scientist Monitor said he seldom has any points to make except the obvious ones. And the Oakland Tribune rather succinctly said plays the piano acceptably. But this was the 50s, from all that I've been told, a very prudish time. In this country we had the Oxford Reviews and people like Blandis and Swan and Noel Coward, so we were familiar with this sort of sophisticated, witty, musical humorists. While in America they had acts like Spike Jones. Spike Jones' idea of comedy is to play hilarious comedy sound effects and to shoot a gun in a theatre, which can't be a good idea. You just ask Abraham Lincoln. However, more risque the novelty records, like the postman has the longest route in town, and she's got the biggest kanakas in Hawaii, which sounds great. I'm going to have to find that. However, Lehrer was more influenced by musical theatre. Up at the top there is Gilbert and Sullivan, so Lehrer's earliest musical memories was playing an old 78 that they had of Gilbert and Sullivan. Down here at the bottom, this is Stephen Sondheim, who wrote West Side Story, and next to him is Sheldon Harnick, who wrote Fiddler on the Roof. Other influences were vaudeville acts like the Marx Brothers and Danny Kaye, down there in the bottom right. Danny Kaye was a particular influence on Tom Lehrer. In 1999, Sir Martin Gilbert, who was the biographer of Winston Churchill and a 20th century historian, named Tom Lehrer as one of the 10 greatest figures in the previous 100 years. So what I want to present is a biography of Tom Lehrer. Thomas Andrew Lehrer was born on the 9th of April 1928 in Manhattan, New York. His father was a successful tie manufacturer. Apparently, a legend in the industry, he had the combination of taste and business sense, and he was very successful. They were ethnically but not religiously Jewish, more to do with the delicatessen and the synagogue. Tom Lehrer has said that in his house, God was primarily an expletive, usually preceded by "oh" or "my" or both. However, his parents were fans of Broadway musicals, and living in New York, the young Lehrer had plenty of opportunities to see musical theatre and vaudeville acts, and like a lot of children at that time, he took piano lessons, which he practiced the absolute minimum. He hated classical music, but he did try to pick out pop tunes on the piano, and his mother noticed this, and she looked around to find him a pop piano teacher, which there weren't so many in those days, but she did find him one. So Lehrer began to take up the piano. Apparently he was writing songs from the age of 8. I don't know how good they were, but apparently so. He also, meanwhile, was getting acquainted with his other lifelong passion of mathematics. He says, "I always enjoyed math, he's American. I remember doing logic puzzles, working out math problems and stuff like that, even as a little kid." Now, he'd skipped a total of 2 years in grammar school. They believed in skipping in those days if they thought you were too bright and disrupting the class. They believed in skipping you. They didn't have Ritalin in those days. And because of this, as a consequence of this, in 1943, at the age of 15, he went to Harvard. He went to Harvard at the age of 15. He says everyone was young then, because everyone who was not young was still in the army. In that time, they had the draft. The draft was still very much alive. And he considered studying English, which he decided involved far too much reading, reading a lot of books, too many of which he might not like. He considered studying chemistry, which he decided was too smelly, so he settled on mathematics, saying, "There were frequent homework assignments, so I didn't really have to study for the exams, because if you can do the homework assignments, you can do the exam. There were no labs, no long reading lists, no termly papers to put off for as long as possible. Perfect for a lazy student."